You guys, welcome to your official 80-day obsession test group. I'm technically posting a few hours early because I said I wasn't going to start posting in the group until tomorrow, but I obviously opened the group up tonight for everybody to be able to start posting, and I saw something important come up. I saw somebody post a question about whether or not you are allowed to move containers around from your workout block or from other meals. And that answer is a hard no. You absolutely cannot pull containers from one meal and move them to another meal. If you're doing that, you're not following time nutrition. Me putting the containers together the way I did with each meal is a massive, massive component of this program and a massive component of time nutrition. So the whole point behind time nutrition is me saying, these are the containers you eat, and this is when you eat them. They go hand in hand. If you start mixing and matching containers, you're no longer doing time nutrition. You're doing 21-day fix type nutrition, which isn't wrong. It's just not 80-day obsession timed nutrition. So if you're looking to do 80-day obsession timed nutrition, you absolutely cannot pull containers and move them around from meal to meal. What you could, so your workout block stays the way it is, right? You have your pre-workout meal, your post-workout supplements and your purple container, and then you have your post-workout meal. That's your workout block, okay? And that always, that grouping always stays together. Obviously, you do have the option to swap out meal option one for your pre-workout meal if you want a smaller meal pre-workout, okay? That block has to stay together, and those containers in each meal have to stay in that meal. As you go throughout the rest of the day, so your meal option one, your meal option two, your meal option three, you can put those meals in whatever order you would like. So even though it says meal option one, meal option two, let's say I say, okay, pre-workout meal, great, I have it, I do my workout, I have my post-workout supplements, I have my post-workout meal, that's done. Now I move on to the rest of my day, and I'm like, time to eat, what do I want? I don't want meal option one, I want meal option two right now. I can put meal option two next, and then I can have meal option three after that, and I can save meal option one as my last meal of the day. So I can move those three meal options around after the workout block, or before the workout block, depending on when you're doing it, but you can't pull containers and move them to different meals. This is a big deal. And I saw a bunch of people in the group answering the girl who posted the question and saying, yeah, you can do it. You guys, please don't do that. That's like, let me just be really clear about that. Please don't answer a question that you're not 1,000% sure about, because the last thing we want to do is give somebody advice that is not accurate right now. So definitely you can tag me if you have a question. You can tag Denis Fay. He's our nutritionist. You can tag Stephanie Saunders. So that way you're tagging one of us that created the program so that we can get back to you and answer you with the correct answer, which is the whole point of the group, right? And I love and appreciate that you guys are in there and in here already and supporting each other and wanting to help each other. But just make sure that, like I said, that you're not so excited to answer somebody that you're like, yeah, I think that's totally okay, if you're not sure it's okay, because then if I happen to miss it or not answer somebody right away, I just don't want them doing it wrong because, you know, they had a few people in the group say that it was okay. So, nope, not even the orange. It goes with the container that, it goes with the meal that I put it in, and it's in meal option three. So it stays with meal option three, okay? You may not move containers around if you want to follow time nutrition, you guys. And I said this on my Facebook page this morning, if you watched it at all. Yes, I'm pacing. I don't pace when I talk. That, you know, like I gave a little bit of tough love and just said, yeah, everybody gets really excited when a new program comes out, right? And then you guys want to know all the ways you can manipulate it, change it, so that you can stay in your comfort zone and you can continue to do things the way that you like to do them. So, and here's my tough love. If you want to do things the way you want to do them, that's fine, but then expect your results. Don't expect the results that I'm guaranteeing. So that's my tough love part. If you want the results that I'm promising, you got to do it my way. If you're happy with the results you've been getting by doing it your way, then you can keep doing it your way. I'm not shaming you at all. I'm just saying that, you know, if you want to follow Time Nutrition, you have to follow it the way I wrote it. That's the Time Nutrition. Should we be finished eating by a certain time? No. This program doesn't have a certain, you know, finish your containers by blah, 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 because some people work out at night. And if they work out at night, you need to eat your workout block. So you need to eat your post-workout meal. And if you work out at 8 o'clock at night and you finish your workout at 9 o'clock at night, you still need to eat your post-workout supplement, you know, your post-workout supplement and your post-workout meal. It's imperative that you do that so that you give your body the fuel that it needs to start the muscle recovery process. If you're like, oh, it's 9 o'clock at night, I don't want to eat this late, and you don't eat that last meal, you're going to be low on calories. Your body's going to start holding on to weight because it's going to need everything that you're giving it because you're not giving it enough, and your muscles aren't going to recover fast enough for the next fun workout that we have in store the next day. So there is no end time of, like, finish your containers around this time. It's based on when you're having your workouts and spacing every 2 to 3 hours throughout your day, especially once you get up as well. Can we have honey or maple syrup on a refeed day? Yeah, it's those ingredients are in a lot of the refeed options, but let's not worry about refeed. That is 6 weeks away, so let's not even go there yet. But as we get closer to refeed, we will talk about it more. And you're still going to follow your containers, you're going to follow the refeed list, and you're going to look at the supplemental yellow list and eat off the supplemental yellow list. But we're not there yet. We're 6 weeks away, so let's focus on day one. Program is great for runners. Can we switch up all options, just not containers? You can't switch up your workout block. Your workout block stays together. So, again, you guys, if you look at your specific meal plan, in there's several options. Like, we show you several sample days of what it could look like based on if your workout's in the morning, if your workout's in the afternoon, if your workout's at night, how you would move meal option 1, 2, and 3 around. So let's say I'm not working out till noon. Maybe I want to have meal option 3 as my very first meal of the day. And then 3 hours goes by and I want to have my pre-workout meal. Then I do my workout, then I have my post-workout supplement, then I have my post-workout meal, then maybe I want my next meal to be meal option 2, so I have that. And then 2 to 3 hours after that, I want to have meal option 1. Then I have meal option 1. But you never separate out your workout block. That whole block stays together, and the other meals move around it. Okay. Sorry, you're getting dizzy. I'll stop moving. I've been sitting all day. I was in meetings for like 5 hours, so I'm like tired of sitting still. Let's see. Yeah, okay. I'm just looking to see if you guys have any more questions really quick. Information and house tour. Yes. Sorry, guys. I'll stand still. No, you cannot split the hour workouts in half. You shouldn't. You guys, look. At the end of the day, if that's what you end up doing and you split the hour workouts, well, you're not doing the same thing because you're not taxing your muscles in the same way. You're only doing a 30-minute workout, right? Like, the energy you have at the end of a 30-minute workout and like, the exhaustion you feel at the end of an hour workout are very different. And if you split the workout up, you're not really, like I said, you're not taxing the muscles in the same way. You're not breaking them down in the same way. So it becomes a different workout program. So again, let's not try to manipulate the program to fit, right? This is where I talk about stepping outside your comfort zone, pushing yourself. This is where I talk about, I talk about self-care in the program a lot. I talk about making time for you and for your goals in the program a lot, and how important that is, and how important it is to say, look, there's 24 hours in a day. I am allowed this 1 hour for myself to work out. I know we're all busy. I know we have jobs, and we have families, and we have obligations, but if you take time to look at your schedule, you can make this work. You can make the Time Nutrition work. You can make the workouts work. You guys, I am busy. I promise. My life is crazy, hectic, 24/7. whether I was filming the workout program or not, I always find time for my workout. Whether I have to get up super early in the morning to get it done, or I have to do it late at night, or if I have to do it in the middle of the day, I make sure I make time for it. We all need to eat throughout the day. You're going to be eating throughout the day. Whether you choose to eat a healthy meal, one of your meal options, or a bag of chips, that's your choice, but you're going to eat throughout the day. I would hope you're not starving yourself. So it's making minor adjustments, and this is a huge part of 80-Day Obsession, and it's a cool part. And if you ask any of the people that were already in the first test group, they'll tell you, like, they had all the same fears, all the same anxieties that you guys are having, which is totally normal when you take on something new, but they just trusted the process, and they were like, okay, well, this is what we have to do, because this is part of being in the test group, and because they had to do it, they just adjusted, and once they adjusted, they actually found their day to be much more organized, much more productive, and things like that. So I promise, once you get in the flow of things, it will become easier. Lauren, did I happen to answer your question about your thyroid in an email today? I got the exact same question in the email today. If you have to take your thyroid medication first thing in the morning and then wait 30 minutes before eating, that's an exception to the rule, obviously, and definitely do that because that's what you need to do. So what you can do is, let's say you were going to work out at 5 a.m. Get up at 4:15, take your thyroid medicine, wait 30 minutes, 4:45. Maybe at 4:45 you have your meal option one, right? Because you're allowed to sub that in instead of your pre-workout meal. And that could be your Shakeology. So you could have Shakeology with a piece of fruit and a scoop of power greens. Drink that. It shouldn't take too long to digest. And you could still start your workout by 5. You don't have to wait the 60 to 90 minutes from eating your pre-workout meal to starting your workout. You could do it in 20 or 30 minutes, right? Like for me, I eat and I go right into my workout. If you're working out in the middle of the day, chances are you're still going to end up waiting that hour to an hour and a half. But the reason that's written like that is to make sure that you digest your food enough, right? Because most people can't do what I do. Most people would get sick if they just finished eating a meal and went right into a workout. I don't. I actually prefer to do it that way. So, Lauren, in regards to it, you can do that. You can take your thyroid medication and then wait. And then eat. If someone were to become pregnant in the middle of the program, I would suggest stopping the program. Here's the thing. It's, you might not know you're pregnant right away, right? Like, you obviously are at least 4 to 5 weeks pregnant before you even figure it out. So that's not the worst thing in the world. But by the time you're at 10, 11 weeks, morning sickness kicks in, exhaustion kicks in, lots of things start kicking in. You're not supposed to be on your back after 14 weeks. We're doing a lot of stability training in the program. Not great when you're pregnant because that's something that goes. So if you were to find out you're pregnant, I would suggest putting 80-Day Obsession on hold. If you're in this group, you can absolutely stay in here with us and keep learning, keep watching, so that after you have the baby and you're ready to come back to it, you've sort of learned and followed along. But I would pause, move over to something else like 21 Day Fix or Country Heat or the prenatal series that I have on Beachbody On Demand. But I wouldn't suggest continuing because you really shouldn't be doing 80-Day Obsession when you're pregnant. Okay, I'm going to take like 2 more questions and then I got to get my little dude in bed. It's way past his bedtime. What about moving the post-workout meal closer to when we finish our workout? You can have, sorry, Crystal, I was making sure I read that accurately. You guys, make sure you're reading this really carefully. So, the thing is Crystal, I guess it would depend on if you're are you having Beachbody Performance or not. It's a little easier for this particular thing if you weren't having your post-workout shake, although I would love for you to have your post-workout shake. I just don't want you to be super full. So let's say you finish your workout at 7, then you would technically need to have your post. If you're having the performance line, you would have your post-workout shake, your recover, with a purple, your fruit. Then you would wait at least an hour after that to have your post-workout meal. However, if you're not using the performance line, you can have your post-workout meal right away after your workout. You're just supposed to have it within an hour of finishing your workout. So if you weren't having recover, you could have your post-workout meal, and that purple container, that purple container moves into your post-workout meal. And again, there is a sample of this in the actual guide. Sorry, I'm trying to find my phone charger before this dies on me. Okay, so again, you guys, make sure you're reading your guide. Make sure you're looking at all the different samples. Like, really analyze it, right? Take the time to look at it and be like, oh, okay, here's what it looks like if I'm using the performance line. Here's what it looks like if I'm not using the performance line. Here's what it looks like if today I have to move my workout to the middle of the day and normally I work out first thing in the morning. Like, really look at this stuff and learn it, because not only is it going to help you be successful, it's going to help you be a more successful coach. Okay. Ashley says she's 2 pounds away from a smaller meal plan. Should she still go with the bigger one? Yeah, you absolutely go with whatever one you fall into right now at your starting weight. Okay, guys, have a wonderful night. Hopefully this cleared up some questions. I'll be in here tomorrow. If you have questions, make sure you're posting them. I'm now going to pin this video to the top of the page, and I'll leave it up there for a while. And then I'll be in here liking photos, commenting on your posts, and all of that stuff. So have a great night, and we'll talk tomorrow. Bye.